Yes, it did.
Oh, that's right. What the fuck am I doing?
Already the arc is cold.
Anyway.
Good night, Pussycats. Good night, Spiky.
I ate the cake, didn't I? Yeah, I did. That's right, it was stale, I forgot.
Absolutely nothing lovable about that particular experience.
Oh yeah, we'll see how the new lights are.
Oh man, he shit his pants up fierce up there. Holy fuck. I love a thing to fight, come out of the bathroom, there he is leaning over the stove, farting himself to death. Like, holy shit. All I hear is you screaming out there like a little girl. Like, what the fuck?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
It's pretty bright.
That is, that's like, and even me, my headlights are partially fogged.
Yeah, you can just polish that out of them, you know.
I don't know if I need to. I don't know if I even need to do that anymore. But look at that. That's
just go get a can of Deep Woods off and spray it on the fucking lenses. Lightly. Don't go too heavy on it. Just lightly. Take it right off. I found that by accident on the Subaru.
What do you do? You like go?
Well, I was spraying myself down with the off, standing next to the car. Next day, I noticed there were clean patches all over the fucking fogged headlights. Oh, I'm like, what the fuck? I looked, it was a spotter pattern from the fucking Deep Woods off.
So you just do a quick Deep Woods off with the
cloth? Went, shh, shh, shh. No, don't touch it with a cloth. Just spray it on there, and it lightened it right up.
I don't need lightning up though. Look, I don't need.
Yeah,
it though.
Don't.
I wouldn't even fuck with it.
I guess there won't be a season 2 of 10-22-63.
Although I did notice a lot of detail went into that though.
Oh yeah,
a
lot. I guess it's more of a mini-series rather than a regular TV show, so.
Well, yeah, well, a lot of work went into that, I can see, even before.
I wish they did that with some of his other fucking books. Because frankly, this is the only time I've ever seen a Stephen King book turned into a fucking movie, you know, anything on television. It was actually good and well done. None of them have ever done with this kind of quality before. Not a single fucking one. I'd like to see them redo The Stand. You know, with some decent actors and acting and sets and stuff like that. And a miniseries that are trying to cram it into, you know, 3 hours. They put it into a miniseries like this that's 10. Then you can tell a story. You know, the book was 1,000 fucking pages. I mean, come on. It's still considered the best work he ever made.
Oh, The Stand, really?
Yeah.
When did you first read that?
God, back in the 80s. Early 80s. Whatever first came out, I read it. It'd be nice to do it to Christine, too.
What the hell is it? Get that thing out of here!
Darnell's do-it-yourself garage. Tool rental by the hour.
Smoking in here and throw you out on your ass. Those guys, they're smoking over there. Hey buddy, you're helping you here, you're helping your friend right out the door. I know a creep when I see one. I think I'm looking at one right now.
You don't know half as much as you think you do, you shitter. Smell of a new car. Best thing except maybe for pussy.
So was Terry complaining about today? Everything?
It's too cold. You're mean. I'm not killing my kitty.
Oh, yeah, she is.
Of course she is. She's feeding it to death.
What's the weight now?
Oh, God. In cat pounds, that cat's 400 pounds, you know? Jesus. Uh-oh.
Pass on.
I'm gonna have to hit.
The timing was perfect on that. I left early, got to the diner early. I was going to hang out and leave on usual time. I was like, I can take no more. Now, of course, then you hear the rich and famous now are rebuilding all their bunkers now.
Actually, they've been doing that for a long time.
Because Trump now is a trigger-happy nuke idiot.
The rich and famous have been building bunkers for the last 7 or 8 years. Actually, they've been doing it since 9/11. Shortly thereafter. That's nothing new. Had nothing to do with Trump at all. That's just the world situation in general. Where you think these big mega bunkers sprung up overnight? You know, it takes years, even decades, to plan out that shit.
Capable
of understanding any of this beyond them.
It's one thing if she was, you know, 45 or 50, then it'd be the regular stubbornness, but now, you know, she don't get much anyway.
Yeah.
Well. You know. Distance bright, but they're bright.
Yeah, where it matters.
Yeah, yeah. I wonder how this would be in the fog.
Don't know.
Yeah, this is a big noticeable difference right here.
Oh, yeah. The camera can see it, too.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. What's it look like on the camera?
Brighter.
Next week, because I want to see the night video of this. I want to see what this looks like compared to...
Well, I notice it's not losing focus yet. It may do that, but it's not losing it yet.
I wonder if that's got something to do with the light speed.
Yeah, better. Well, the more light, the better the focus works.
Yeah, the minute in the garage you popped them on, I saw it right away. I was like, well, yeah, that's, they're whiter. I'm not looking for brighter, dimmer, better. I'm just looking at it. I'm sick and tired of these things popping like this. Fuck.
So,
but those are his low beams, though. You know how I know? Because when he came around the corner, he popped them down.
Yeah.
So that's how I know. Yeah, the brights really don't. They're like a hair better, but they don't do that much. This would be better on a dark road like this, but. Driving a different car.
Yeah.
Sometime Monday. I think it's Monday morning, but it's only Westchester. But that's nothing.
Yeah.
So what I'll do is I'll come by probably Monday morning. I'll try to get in before 9:30 if possible. If not, I'll come in after 4:45. That way I don't miss all the fanfare, you know, when I come in with a bag, you know. God. That's so fucked up, those two left because of him and his mouth. Oh my god.
Yeah, that's what Wayne told me. Yeah.
I believe every bit of that. Yeah, when I came down, I said, well, where's your help? And you're like, well, this one's got kids. And I'm thinking, okay, for whatever reason. Well, there's the whatever reason.
No, I had him for about 3.5 months. Up until about September of 2015. Then I didn't get Sheldon back for another 2 months after that. A little while.
Now we know why.
Yeah.
Fuck. Wasn't one of them there the other day?
Yeah, he wasn't there to work though. Sheldon was doing something to his car.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Sheldon's, I don't know, his cousin, I guess, John. John was with us about a month, you know. And, what do you call it? Good worker, you know, he was hustling, doing Cerrito's thing with the tires. That's what he was doing. But the thing is, he has problems. One of which is, he doesn't like any kind of confrontations or anything like that. And when you do yell at him or anything like that, he's going to retreat. He's going to go back home. He's going to stay in his room for a fucking week and a half.
Oh, shit. How old is he?
He's about 20, 18, 20.
It's got to be in you.
It's like agoraphobia, something like that. You know, it's a mental illness. And, of course, David's yelling and carrying on everything else, of course. You know, he didn't want to be around there anymore.
My mom said something, you know, halfway through the Navy or whatever, and she said, I wish you were like you were when you went in. I go, what do you mean? You know, and she said, you're shy and quiet and nice, and she said, now there that I can see a side of you that, you know, you don't see often too much. Came out in Costco once. Somebody tried cutting in front of us.
I know, I heard.
it has to be in you to, you know, to be like that, yeah. You know. Whether it's already there and you have to bring it out, or you just, you know, it has to be in you to be like that. It sucks if he's got a mouth like that. That's really too bad. Everyone's in for everyone.
Yeah. Attitude.
The thing I always found out in this life is somebody has got a big mouth like that, and then you come along with a bigger mouth and put them in their place. They don't like that.
Yeah.
Because they want to be the end all, say all, no, the end all, be all with the mouth, and, you know. Either a combination of, you know, getting handed more responsibility or going up in rank, or you have to have it or you're not going to function, you know, that's it. Then you have to, you know, not only stick up for yourself, start sticking up for people under you. This is what's right, and this is how you do it. And I would start low and say, okay, then you get to the, you know, you gotta do. But he's in his own little world down there, and he can do what he wants, pretty much.
Yeah, I guess so. The old man let him get away with it for years.
Now, enjoy it while you can.
Yeah.
That's what I said to somebody. I said, enjoy your mouth and your little power here, because it's only going to be about a year and a half. When you go back to the boat, this ain't going to stand. You know it, and I know it. Yeah. So... enjoy your little mouth and your little power here, because this ain't gonna go after this. Speak too much after that, because you know it was right.
Supposed to be taking care of that shit around the shop, everything like that. I mean, doing shit. Telling the old man, bring the fucking loader down here, because the forklift is out of commission, so I'll bring the, at least for heavy weights.
Office is a pig pen, the whole...
Well, that's always been that way, but...
You're to blame, apparently.
No, not for that. But, back room, yes, I don't give a fuck. I'll leave it messy, don't bother me. Keeps them the fuck out of there. They're moving shit around and I can't find stuff.
No, yeah, right. Yeah.
I'll bring the fucking loader down here. I'll run it. I can climb into it, just climb into it. I cannot climb up and down that fucking machine. I'm up and down.
I saw the machine
once.
Yeah.
That's it. You're lucky I can do that much. And I need someone to help me load that fucking bucket with the little shit. You know, I'm thinking David could be doing that. One of his kids come down and do it. No.
Of course not.
Tell the old man, you better get somebody.
He was gone for a month. I swear to God, Jim, I would come down and I would tell the boss, I'll come. I want to work full straight hour days, but I'll come down here and I said, I don't even want to get paid. I'll just do it to do it.
You know,
what do you want me to do? What do you need me to do? And I'd come down and help out.
I could do it myself, I would do it. But I'm not physically able to do it anymore, and I'm getting worse. I can't do it anymore. You need to have somebody down there, a strong young back, to lift that heavy shit and throw it in a fucking bucket. But it literally is no other way. I can't walk the magnet over there. If I could, I would. Hmm. But it's too much obstacles in the fucking way.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't take it out on the road to get it over there. Right. That would be the end.
Right.
So it's going to have to be loaded by hand. All that shit over there in that little gate.
So what's the deal with Bob now? Is this too old?
Well, he's having shoulder surgery. He's got carpal tunnel. He fell off a fucking ladder and fucked himself all up.
Wow.
So, yeah, he's not going to be doing much. He doesn't much care to listen to David's mouth either.
Yeah. Shit. Damn. Oh, my God.
But, yeah, he's also, you know, he's, I believe he is actually 70 years old now. And, you know, can't be doing that shit.
Even a crane operator.
Well, because of his injuries, he can't climb up and down that crane.
Right. What kind of shape is he in?
Well, now, not too good, because, you know, he's a little beat up. He's got to heal up from that shit.
Mm. The older you are, the longer it takes.
And he wants to sell his house and move south, or into Pennsylvania, one or the other, which I guess is moving south.
Nothing in Pennsylvania. You were there.
Yeah. Well, that's what the idea. He wants to get the hell out of there. He's in New Milford. He's just down the road from the Home Depot.
Hmm.
He's got a little, one of the few private houses left in that stretch.
I was going to say, where? If he's done, yeah. Like, where?
There's not many, I'm told there's not many private residences.
No, there's not.
One of them is Bob's. Look for the one with a big flatbed and a bunch of machinery out back. That's his house.
Huh.
It's basically a shack, but it's a very valuable one.
Yeah.
Because they want the property.
Sure, I bet they do. Because when we go to the flea market and we go to the McDonald's and we pass that way, you know, there ain't no houses there. I know that area well enough. I'm trying to think, that's where does he live?
Yeah.
Probably, you know, I can tell exactly where he lives. If the Home Depot is over here, mm-hmm. and we're headed towards, you go to the Gaylordsville, he's on this side, going slightly down the hill. I think I know exactly where his house is. There's only a couple of three houses.
Yeah.
And I mean a couple of three, that's it.
So he's got plans, you know, he doesn't want to be hanging around with us.
I wonder what the town's going to give him.
The town's not giving him anything.
Yeah, I mean, if he sells, not the town, I mean, whoever...
Whatever developer buy, I don't know. A lot.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It is...
Probably at least $500,000, maybe more.
Yeah.
That just got... Focus came right back.
Hmm. With the brights...
No, the other guy's headlights hit it, and it kind of went away for a bit, then it came right back.
Because it sees better light?
I guess. The more light you have, the better the autofocus works to these cameras. They're not really that sensitive in, you know, the dark. David said her dead was Eugene.
Who's that?
He's dead. He died in a house fire about a year ago.
Shit. You told me, I forgot.
Yeah, well, he had a serious drug habit.
Damn.
I mean, it worked okay. You'd have to supervise him, though. You couldn't just, you know, leave him alone because he didn't know what the hell he was doing.
Hmm.
You told him to put air in a tire. He'd put air in a tire until it exploded, you know.
Ah.
See, and it almost happened. Ew. It almost happened, but... I caught that in time. After that, I kept a closer eye on him.
Hmm.
And it's one of the situations where this is my brain on a lot of drugs over many years, you know? He was our age.
Hmm.
Not like we can hire the fucking illegal aliens, because they'll cut him. Yeah, he runs his mouth at them, they'll cut him. And go back home to their country, you know?
I'm serious, I'd go over there and I'd help out every day or every other day, or, you know, I'd put in some hours a day and I wouldn't even want to get paid. I'd say, all right, you know, what do you want done? But, you know, even if he sat in his chair right there by where the vice is, by the table vice, and just sit there and point and say, okay, cut up that pipe, put it, okay, get it, what do you want me to do now? You know, go cut that pipe and put it in that bin, okay? You know, blah, blah, blah. I'd help clean up in there, do some outside work.
Well, you got the same problem I do, Oscar. You're getting fucking old.
Hell yeah.
There's only so much of that you can do.
That's what I said. I'm right behind you. I'm feeling it. I can piddle around the shop, but still, I wouldn't have to listen.
My mistake was I pushed a little too hard up and back because they were breathing down the old man's neck with fucking timelines and deadlines and fines and everything else, and I'm pulling fucking 12 and 13, 14 hour fucking days sometimes. Now I'm feeling it now.
How would you feel at the end of one of those days?
Extremely bad. God. And it hasn't gone away. It's gotten worse. And it's a fucking rare day when I don't have some kind of fucking pain. It's a rare night that I sleep more than 3, 4, 5 hours.
Really?
When pain hits you in the middle of the night, you're up. That's it. No point even trying to fucking sleep. Get up, read a book, watch TV, play on a computer, whatever.
What's the most you sleep?
Sometimes I'll sleep the whole night. Sometimes I'll pop awake at 2:33 in the morning with screaming fucking pain in my sciatic, and that's it. Or my feet or some other place. And you're up. It's done. You're not getting back to bed.
An aspirin don't do shit, huh?
No. Yeah. Don't even take the edge off anymore.
Damn.
And there's no treatment for that.
My mom says the same thing.
I mean, all they do is give you stronger and stronger painkillers if that's what you happen to want. That's not what I want. It's not life. Take the fucking pain.
Mom says the same thing. She says she doesn't bother too much unless she's excruciating. Then she takes a pill to quell it. She's got problems in her right foot. She's on a cane now. This last 6 months, she's on a cane.
Oh, I know the feeling. I have problems with my right foot. I know.
So she's like, and she can't feel her foot, so that's why she can't drive.
I can still feel it. And sometimes that's the problem. It hurts. Never healed right after I fell off the fucking forklift for the second goddamn time.
When did you fall off?
During the cleanup, twice.
Damn.
Just lost my footing and boom. You know, you missed the step, falling hard, that's it. Ankles are fucked up now. Said it would get worse.
When I came back from Philly, the lady was asking me if there was a recall. I said, well, it depends. If you're doing a mass recall or is it just me or a handful of us? And I said, if it was me, and I was like, one of this, maybe a dozen on the ship that got recalled, I said, there better be all kind of concessions for Petty Officer Miller.
Yep.
All kinds. And I said, I can take the long hours. But I said, when I get tired, I go. And I said, I said, I couldn't take part in fire party no more. I said, I'll do the man overboard drills and shit. I said, I'll go to my GQ station. I said, PT, there are going to have to be concessions for that.
Yeah.
I said, you're going to have to be all kind of, you know, I said, I might need, you know, I said, I would have head of the line because I'm first class, but I said, my God, you know, I said, I get tired. I can't keep up like I could. I can still do my job. But I said, there'd have to, she asked me if I could go back into the supply. I said, I could. There'd have to be a shitload of concessions here.
I imagine there's been a lot of changes there, too.
Oh, yeah.
You've been out 10 years
now. Even if I adapted, even if I got out and readapted, you know, and say I picked it right back up again, I said, you're talking about, you know, there'd have to be all kind of, you know, exemptions here for me. You know, and I said, this is now, let alone another 5 or 10 years from now.
Yeah.
I said, well, I could still keep up. But boy, oh boy, there'd have to be a lot of, oh, by the ways, no more running up and down ladders like I was. Oh, you know, no more of this, you know, helping people lift heavy shit and valves. And then, you know, how long would I be able to keep this up for?
Well, I know.
That's what I told her. I said, there'd have to be all kind of, you know, oh, by the way, it's for the freaking grandpa here.
Yeah.
You know, that's exactly what I said. Messed up as that sounds. Now, I said, if this was happening all over, then it'd be a little different. Then there'd be, you know, but if it was just, you know, me and a handful of people on the ship, now I'd get trouble getting up. I'd be tired coming in. No more to just, you know, 15, 18 hour shifts, that's it, 12 on, 12 off, or that's it, 3:30, 4 o'clock, time to go home.
You
know?
Yeah.
We're still behind me, why?
I don't know. Going to the deli, maybe.
Probably. Go back. I said, I don't know. I said, I'm pissed at traveling, but I'm pissed at bullshit. But I said, mentally I could, physically, no. Nowhere near like I was. He got me when I was 42, 45, and then it might have been, you know, some bumps. But now, no, not at 50. No, it's trouble now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know?
Now you really are an old man.
You know? Oh, yeah.
On a ship full of fucking 18 to 22 year olds.
Running around, running circles around you, you know?
All right, Scott.
All right, I'll pop in Monday or Tuesday.
Yep, I'll be around.
I miss Tiger coming out.
Yeah,
that's sad.
Yep.